We, you know, members have submitted their voting sheets who are not here. I believe there's been an agreement by both Republican and Democratic conferences to how to operate committee meetings. And so I am, you know, representing folks, as is, want to welcome Senator George Borrello, who's acting as the ranking member of this committee. And I believe we may have some members who may be calling in on a conference line if there are any questions. Basically, the package of bills is dealing with COVID-related emergencies, dealing with local governments. Our local governments are going through, you know, a very difficult time in dealing with an unprecedented number of issues, both health-related and economically and socially-related and mental health issues. And so we're really trying to delegate as much as we can to the local governments the authority to make some of the decisions they may need to make so that we're not encumbering them in any way. And that, I think, is pretty much what the bills that we have before us are. I don't know, Senator Borrello, would you like to make any initial comments?
Thank you. In fact, I just want to echo what you've said. You and I both have county government experience and understand what our county governments, in particular all local governments, are going through. So I appreciate the packet of bills here to help ease that burden. And I'm glad to see, as a 10-year veteran of local government, that we're doing something to at least to help ease the burden a bit.
Okay. Thank you, Senator.
Thank you.
And with that, I will ask Chelsea Lemon, Legislative Director, to go to the first bill.
Okay. First bill is Senate Bill 8122B by Senator Comrie, an act in relation to extending the deadline for the filing of applications and renewal applications for real property tax abatement programs.
And again, my understanding is this bill allows the local jurisdictions to make those decisions. Okay. Is there any questions? I don't know if there's anyone on the call that has any questions.
I'm good.
Okay. Then
I'll move the bill.
Motion by Senator Borrello, second by myself. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Aye.
Aye. And we have, that's referred to rules.
Yep. Oh, I vote.
Okay.
Next is Senate Bill 8138B by Senator Martinez, an act to amend the real property tax law in relation to special deferments and installment plans during the COVID-19 state of emergency.
And again, this is delegating to local governments to make those decisions. Any questions?
No questions.
Okay.
Shall I move the bill?
Yes.
Okay, yes.
Okay, Senator Borrello has moved the bill. I will second, and that is Senator Brooks, I know, is on the phone with us, and we have voting sheets from the other members. All in favor? Opposed? And that is also, that is referred to finance. The next bill.
Senate Bill 8236A by Senator Gorin, an act relating to authorizing local governments to extend building permits and local zoning boards of appeals and local planning boards active approvals for a period of up to 120 days, and providing for the repeal of such provisions upon the expiration thereof.
Again, this defers to local governments, but the importance of this, I think, is that while we have been on pause, there's an awful lot of development that will start taking place once, you know, we're moving forward. And I think it's important so that development can take place. This is to allow them, the local level, they choose any permit, planning board approval, zoning board approval that has already been approved, to allow them to just continue for 120 days those approvals. Otherwise, they have to go back to the drawing board, hold new hearings, delaying moving forward. And then also allowing them, because I know a lot of my municipalities have been holding off on applications because they've been doing things remotely, that, you know, require and have more community involvement. And so I think this way things have been approved, can move forward, and then these boards can move forward with discussions of other matters. Okay, any questions?
Just a comment.
Sure.
I appreciate the fact that during this, you know, COVID time, especially during this pandemic, this is a good thing to help keep things moving. I'm a fan of open government, and I think that it needs to follow the process. But in this particular circumstance, because people are operating on skeleton crews, and these are volunteer boards, many of those folks cannot meet effectively. So this is a good way to, as you said, expedite those projects so they continue to move forward.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. I guess I'll make the motion.
Second?
Second by Senator Barillo. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? And that is also referred to rules. The next bill.
All aye votes. The next bill is Senate Bill 8251B by Senator Kaminsky. An act to amend the general municipal law in relation to the determination of points for service award programs for volunteer firefighters and volunteer ambulance workers during a state disaster emergency and providing for the repeal of such provisions upon expiration thereof.
Okay, is there any questions on this?
Just a comment on the bill itself.
Yes.
As a result of the restrictions that have been placed on group meetings and the like, normal training programs can't take place right now. Most of the departments are doing a form of online training, but this allows the active members to continue to participate and meet the requirements of the LOSAP program, given the restrictions on that have been placed on us for the COVID-19. So I think this is very important, and I think it addresses the needs both of the community and the departments.
I agree. Thank you, Senator Brooks, who, in addition to being a state senator, is an active volunteer firefighter who provides a lot of information to many of us and guidance on those issues. Okay, I'll take a motion to approve. Senator Barillo,
yes.
Second by myself. All in favor? Opposed?
Aye.
Aye.
And I think, Chelsea, you said all the bills so far have been unanimously
correct.
Approved. Okay.
Yep.
And the final bill?
That is referred to rules.
Kaminsky Bill 8251B is referred to rules.
Next bill is Senate Bill 8413 by Senator Benjamin. An act in relation to authorizing municipalities to place a moratorium on tax foreclosures and tax lien sales.
And again, this is delegating to localities to make those decisions, but I think there are going to be a lot of people that are really going to be hurting, and we're going to need to try to help them as best we can, and I think this legislation will do that to some extent. Questions? You want to move the bill?
I'll move whatever you want me to do.
Okay, moved by Senator Barillo, seconded by myself. Any questions? All in favor? Opposed? And referred to rules, also unanimous?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is there any other business to come before this committee? Hearing none, this meeting is adjourned. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Senator Barillo, and
thank you, and
everyone on the staff.
I gave her this tag. Yes, I gave her a copy of it. Thank you.